Solving linear programs in two dimensions, like the following problem, is surprisingly easy. The technique I'll be showing you is sometimes called the graphical method, and I'll go over it step by step. As the name suggests, the method involves graphing the constraints. This is the line minus x plus y equals 3. If we take the coefficients of the x and y variables and form a vector out of them, then this vector points in a direction that's normal to the line. If we shift the line in the direction of the normal vector, the right-hand side increases. And if we shift in the opposite direction, the right-hand side decreases. Minus x plus y greater than or equal to 3 corresponds to the half space the normal vector is pointing in. Since we want minus x plus y less than or equal to 3, this corresponds to the other half space. We repeat this for each of the constraints. For the next constraint, the coefficients form the vector minus 2, 1. Since it's a greater than or equal to constraint, we take the half space in the direction of the normal vector. For x plus y less than or equal to 4, we take the half space opposite of the normal vector since we're dealing with a less than or equal to constraint. We do this for the last two constraints. These two constraints force x and y to lie in the positive quadrant. This final area is called the feasible region, and represents the points satisfying all of the constraints. Now, we want to minimize minus 2x minus y. This is the line minus 2x minus y equals 0, and its normal vector. Minimizing the objective corresponds to shifting this line in the direction opposite of the normal vector. We try shifting as much as we can such that this line still intersects the feasible region at some point. The final line is minus 2x minus y equals minus 6, so the optimal value is minus 6. But what are the x and y values? Notice that this optimal point, which is indicated as the red dot, occurs where the orange and green constraints are satisfied at equality. So, to find the optimal point, we just need to solve for x and y in these equations. The optimal point turns out to be x equals 2, y equals 2. Note that there is only one optimal solution in this case, and it occurs at a vertex, or corner point, of the feasible region. But is this always the case? Let's change the objective to minimize minus x minus y. We again plot the line, and since we're minimizing the objective, we shift the line in the direction opposite the normal vector. In this case, we see that the entire edge of this feasible region is optimal, so there are infinitely many optimal solutions. Finally, there are cases when a linear program has no solution. Let's change the constraints a bit by removing this third constraint and changing the x coefficient in the second constraint. After we do this, the feasible region changes to this. In this case, we can shift the objective line as much as we want, and so this problem is unbounded. The final case is when the feasible region itself is empty. For example, if we took our original constraints but changed the third constraint, then there doesn't exist any point that satisfies all of these constraints. Let's recap. A linear program can be infeasible. It can be unbounded. It can have a unique optimal solution at a vertex. Or an entire edge or face is optimal, in which case there are infinitely many optimal solutions. One thing to note, when a linear program does have an optimal solution, there's always an optimal solution at a vertex. In the first two cases, the linear program doesn't have an optimal solution. When it has a unique optimal solution, it's at a vertex. And when there are infinitely many optimal solutions, there are optimal solutions at vertices. This implies we can just check the vertices of the feasible region for the optimal solution. But how do we do this intelligently? We'll explain this in the next video, when we talk about the simplex method. If this was helpful and you want to see more, please like and subscribe to support the channel.